Hey everyone, welcome to the new video from Talent Battle. This video is the fourth part where we will discuss previous year questions with solutions asked by TCS. The focus will be more on time speed distance concept. If you want us to prepare a video for questions asked by any company, just put that company name in the comment box. We'll be creating video for that company. But before that, don't forget to subscribe to our channel, as we'll be posting all the important campus updates on our YouTube channel. So let's start with today's questions. Let's check this question. Raj, while driving along the highway, saw the road markers which are at equal distance from each other. He crosses the markers every 20 seconds. If he increases the speed by X meters per second, he crosses markers at every 15 seconds. But if he increases his speed by y meters per second, he crosses the markers at every 10th second. If y minus x is equal to 40 meters per second, then what is the distance between two markers? Now, we can do this question step by step. Everyone check. Suppose this is the distance on the highway which Raj is covering or driving. Now, what they have said, there are some markers which are at equal distance from each other. So suppose marker 1, marker 2, marker 3, marker 4 and so on. So Raj has started from here. He crosses the markers after every 20 seconds. So the distance, this particular distance is traveled by Raj in just 20 seconds. So for every marker he is taking 20 seconds. So what I will do, I will consider initial speed of Raj as a meter per second. We don't know the exact speed. So what I will do, I will consider the initial speed as A. So what will be the distance covered by Raj? As we know, the formula for distance is equal to speed into time. Distance we need to calculate. Speed I have already considered as A. And the time taken by the Raj to cover each marker is 20 seconds. So I can say the distance for each marker is 20A. 20 is the time, A is the speed, so 20 into A, that distance will be covered. Suppose I will consider this as first equation. Now then what has happened? If he increases the speed by X, he crosses the markers at every 15 seconds. Now one thing you need to understand, though he is increasing his speed, it will affect the time, but the distance is going to be the same. So when the speed is increased, okay, what I will do, distance is going to be the same, so I will write distance as it is. What will happen to the speed? If he increases the speed by X meters, so original speed I have considered as A, so new speed will become A plus X. This is my new speed. And then he crosses the markers at every 15 seconds. So time they have given as 15. So what equation I can have? Distance is equal to 15A plus 15x, correct? So this is the equation which I am having. Now I can put the distance as 20a over here, which I have got from the first equation. So rather than writing distance, I will write 20a over here is equal to 15a plus 15x. So 5a is equal to 15x. A will be, I can say, or if I want to put the value of x will be 5 by 15, which is A by 3. So value of X I'm having in terms of A, which is X is equal to A by 3. Now similarly, I can find out the equation for Y. Okay, just I will write it over here. When the speed is increased by Y, so as we know, distance is going to be the same. Speed will become, initial speed was A plus Y. Then he crosses the marker at every 10 seconds. So now the time is 10. So into 10 I need to do. So just check distance. I will put it as 20a, as I have done in the previous equation also. So 10a plus 10y. So 10a will go on to that side. So that will become 10a is equal to 10y. So a is equal to y. So now I'm having the values of x and y in terms of a. Now what they have asked me, if y minus x is equal to 40, so they have given me one statement, I will write over here, y minus x is equal to 40. As you can check, already I know y is nothing but a, so I will write a over here. Value of x is, which I have found out, a by 3, so I will write a by 3 is equal to 40. So just do the calculation, 3a minus a, which is 2a by 3, is equal to 40. So a is going to be 14 into 3, 120, 120 by 2 is 60. So value of a is 60. But what is a? A is the initial speed which we have considered. But we need to find out the distance. What was the distance we considered? Distance is equal to 20 into a. So I can write over here, distance is equal to 20 into a is nothing but 60. So this will be 1200. So answer for this question is going to be 1200 meters. Just by creating three different equations, initially we found out the initial speed and then we got the distance. So the answer is A. Let's check this question. A passenger train takes 5 hours less for a journey of 360 km if its speed is increased by 50 kmph from the normal speed. Then they have asked the normal speed of the train to the nearest kilometer per hour. So as we are dealing with distance, speed, time, so I will write the basic formula, distance is equal to speed into time. Then what they have said, a passenger train takes 5 hours less for a 360 km if its speed is increased by 50 kmph. So one thing we know, the distance is 360 km. So I will write 360 km over here. Initial speed we don't know, so I will consider the initial speed or the normal speed as x. And the time taken by the normal, I will consider normal, whenever it is traveling normal speed, I will consider it as t. So this is the first equation. Whenever train travels at normal speed, which is x, it will take time as t. Now what has happened? A passenger train takes 5 hours less if the speed is increased by 50. As we know, distance is going to be the same. So 360 will be the distance. If the speed is increased by 50, original or the normal speed was x, so new speed will be x plus 50. What will happen to the time? It takes 5 hours less, so I can just write t minus 5. Now what we need to do, we ultimately want to find out the normal speed, so we want to find out x, so we need to substitute t. How we can do that? I will put the value of t as 360 by x into this equation. So what will happen? 360 is equal to x plus 50. Rather than writing t, I will write 360 divided by x minus 5. Now, once you solve this equation, you will get the value of x, which is the normal speed of train. Now, this thing can be achieved by two ways. One, by multiplying x plus 50 to this bracket. Or if you don't want to enter into calculation or multiplication of the bracket, you can directly use the option. I want to find out the value of x. Suppose I will take the value of x as 50. So suppose the first option is 60, sorry, x is 60. What will happen? 360 is equal to 60 plus 50 is 110 into 360 divided by 60 minus 5. So as we know, 360 divided by 60 is nothing but 6. 6 minus 5 is 1. 1 into 110 will be 110. So it is not equal to 360. So the first option is wrong. If I put second option, which is 40, what will happen? X plus 50 means it will become 40 plus 50. And then 360 by 40. I'm just replacing the value of x as 40 minus 5. So 360 by 40, as you can check, it is 40 into 9. 9 minus 5 is 4. And 40 plus 50 is 90. 90 into 4 is nothing but 360. So as you can check, left hand side is equal to right hand side. And hence the answer is 40. If you are not comfortable using the option, just you need to multiply x plus 50 to this bracket. And in the end, you will get the value of x as 40 only. So the answer is B. A and B are traveling in the same direction. B is traveling at a constant speed of 55 kmph and the distance between A and B is 1.5 km. If A crosses B within 1 minute, what is the speed of A? Now what they have given, both A and B are traveling in the same direction. So suppose I will draw A over here, B over here. B is traveling at a constant speed of 55 kmph. So this data they have given. distance between A and B is 1.5 km. If A crosses B within 1 minute, so if A is crossing B within 1 minute, that means he is covering a distance of 1.5 km in 1 minute. So what they have asked, what is the speed of A? So I will just write down over here, distance traveled by A in 1 minute is 1.5 km. So if I want to take it or convert it into kilometer per hour, so in 60 minutes, how much distance A will cover? If in 1 minute it is covering 1.5 km, so in 60 minutes, 60 into 1.5, it is 90 km. So I can say A will cover 90 km distance whenever it is traveling in the same direction with B. But you cannot directly take the speed of A as 90, as that speed is nothing but the relative speed of A. Now, what is the concept of relative speed? When two objects are moving in the same or opposite direction, I will just draw over here. Suppose two objects are moving in the same direction. One car is traveling at a speed of suppose 90, another car is traveling at a speed of 40. So whenever we are considering both the cars, we will consider their relative speed. In this case, their relative speed will be, if both are traveling in the same direction, you need to do u minus v. Suppose this is u, suppose this is v. Nothing but in this case, it will be 40 kmph. So if two cars are traveling in the same direction, their relative speed will be minus. If two cars are traveling in the opposite direction, then their relative speed will be, suppose one speed is u, another speed is v, then you need to do u plus v. So the 90 kilometer answer which we have got, that is not the speed of A. That is the relative speed when A and B are in contact with each other. So I can say relative speed is 90 km per hour. But we want to calculate the speed of A. As you can check, both the objects are going in the same direction. So the relative speed in this case will be speed of A minus speed of B. So speed of A, which or the relative speed which I have got, it is 90. Speed of A is nothing but, I need to calculate, so I will consider it as A. Speed of B I have got, or I know, which is 55. So A will be 90 plus 55, that is going to be 145 kmph. So the relative speed was 90, but the speed of A will be 90 plus 55, 145. So the answer is A.
A motorboat covers a certain distance downstream in 30 minutes, while it comes back in 45 minutes. If the speed of stream is 5 km per hour, what is the speed of the boat in still water? So this question belongs to boats and stream concept, in which they have given motorboat covers speed downstream or the distance downstream in 30 minutes. So downstream, the concept is nothing but whenever the direction of the river and the direction of boat is the same. So what I will do, if I consider the speed of the boat as u and speed of the river as v, as you can check, if they both are going in the same direction, so downstream speed will be, in that case, u plus v, where I need to add speed of boat and speed of river. Now what they have given, distance traveled by downstream and distance traveled by upstream is same. So I will just write down over here, distance traveled by downstream is equal to distance traveled by upstream. What is the formula for distance? As we know, distance is nothing but speed into time. So for downstream, I need to write downstream speed. I will consider downstream speed, or as we know, I have written the formula u plus v. So I will write u plus v, which is downstream speed. What is the time taken by downstream to go downstream? It is 30 minutes. So distance is nothing but speed into time. Speed I have written. For time, I need to convert that into hours. So 30 by 60. Again, distance by upstream. Distance is speed into time. Now what is upstream? Upstream is nothing but whenever the direction of the river and the direction of boat is against each other. Then what will happen to the speed of boat? If the speed of boat is u and the speed of river is v, then I can say upstream is equal to u minus v. So that will be the speed while going upstream. So distance is equal to speed into time. Speed I know while going upstream is u minus v, and the time taken by the boat to go to upstream is 45 minutes. So upstream is like coming back to the original point. 45 minutes, I need to convert that into hours. So now we need to solve this. What will happen? 30 into 1, 30 into 2, 15 into 3, 15 into 4. As they have already given us the speed of stream, stream is nothing but v, which is 5. So u plus 5, I will multiply this 4 on the left side. So 4 into u plus 5, and I will take this 2 on the right side. So 6 into u minus 5. Just we now need to solve this. 4u plus 20 is equal to 6u minus 30. So this will be 2u is equal to 50. Value of u is going to be 25 kmph. Just simple calculations. So to solve this, we need to know the concept of downstream and upstream, and I have equated two distance, and from that I got the value of speed of boat, which is 25. So the answer is D.
If you like this video, click on the like button. For any doubts, suggestions or feedback, please comment on this video and subscribe to our channel to stay tuned to various placement updates. Press the bell icon for notifications. Thank you.